In part one of our instructional video series on the AEMC Micro-Ohmmeter Model 6240, we explain how to set up, run, and save a measurement test. In part two, we now show you how to download the saved test to a computer using AEMC's DataView software. This video assumes DataView with the Micro-Ohmmeter control panel has been installed on your computer. DataView installation is the subject of a separate AEMC video. The DataView Micro-Ohmmeter control panel is the primary interface for connecting with the Model 6240, downloading test results, and viewing the data on the screen. You can also use the control panel to set up tests, view measurement data in real time, and configure the instrument. The Model 6240 communicates through a USB cable that comes with the product. Insert one end of the cable into the instrument and the other into the computer. To begin the download procedure, open the Micro-Ohmmeter control panel by clicking its icon on the desktop. When the control panel is open, we can establish a connection between the computer and the Model 6240. To do this, click Instrument in the control panel menu bar, and then select the Connect option. The Connection dialog box appears, which enables you to select the communication port, the communication rate, and the instrument model. Click the Communication Port field to display a drop-down list of available ports and select the appropriate one. Next, select the communication rate. For the Model 6240, this is 9600. Note that this rate may already be selected, as is the case here. Finally, ensure that the appropriate instrument model number is selected. When you have completed all three fields on the connection dialog, click OK. The control panel now connects to the instrument. When this is completed successfully, the word connected appears in the lower right corner of the control panel status bar. You can now download test results. To do this, click Instrument in the menu bar and select Download. After a few moments, the Select Test dialog box appears. This lists all tests currently stored on the instrument. You can download individual tests by selecting them, or use the Select All button to download the entire contents of the instrument's memory. In our example, there is only one test stored, so select it and click Download. When the download is complete, the navigation pane on the left side of the control panel window lists the object's name, as well as any tests contained within that object. Clicking on the name of the test displays the measurement data in the data pane on the right side of the control panel window. As you can see, when first open, a test can have a limited amount of data due to the limits of the Model 6240 interface. You can augment this data by clicking Edit in the menu bar and then selecting the Edit option. This displays the Session Summary Properties dialog box. This dialog box consists of four tabs. The first is named Test, and it lets you enter explanatory information about the testing session. For example, you can enter a more meaningful name, the date of the next measurement session, a one-line description, and additional descriptive comments. You can also enter temperature correction data, including temperature format, metal type and temperature coefficient for the material tested, measurement temperature, and reference temperature. This data is used to calculate the temperature offset, as explained in the Model 6240 documentation. The Object tab lets you change the name of the object in which a test is stored. In this case, we will leave the name unchanged. The Operator tab enables you to enter information about the person who conducted the test. Initially, this tab is blank. To enter data, click the Edit button near the bottom of the screen. The Session Properties dialog box now appears. This has three tabs: Operator, Site, and Custom. In the Operator tab, you can enter information about the person who conducted the test. You can also choose from a list of previously created operator records. For demonstration purposes, we earlier created records for three operators. When we select one, the person's information automatically populates the fields in this tab. When this tab is complete, click OK. The final tab in the Session Summary Properties dialog box is named Site. This lets you enter information about the location where the test was performed. When you click Edit to enter information into this tab, the Session Properties dialog box appears. Open the Site tab. As with the Operator tab, you can complete the displayed fields or select an existing name from the site list. We have created an example site called Acme, so we will select it to automatically fill the remaining fields on this dialog box. The Custom tab in the Session Properties dialog box is for adding custom fields to DataView reports created from this record. In our simple demonstration, we will leave this tab unchanged, so click OK to return to the Session Summaries Properties dialog box, and click OK a second time to save your changes. You can now view the complete test record. This includes information about the test operator, the test site, the instrument model and other test-related information, data related to the temperature offset, the test measurement data itself as recorded on the Model 6240 instrument, and finally, any additional comments. To save the complete updated test on the computer, click File in the menu bar and select Save. You will be prompted to enter a file name for the saved test data. You can now view the downloaded and edited test data as a DataView report. To do this, with the test selected, click File in the Control Panel menu bar and choose Create DataView Report. By default, this report consists of a cover sheet and a test summary worksheet. To save the report to the computer, click File when viewing the report, and then click Save and specify a location for the saved report file. Note that DataView includes a number of features that enable you to customize your report, displaying your test results for a wide variety of users and purposes. These report generation features are described in detail in the DataView help. This video concludes our two-part series on setting up, downloading, and analyzing test results for the AEMC Model 6240 Micro-Ohmmeter. For more information about this instrument, please visit the AEMC website. And be sure to visit our YouTube channel for additional videos about the many products offered by AEMC.